choosing our words carefully here on the Superstation TBS, fully cognizant of the opportunity to change the course of human events with our words.
And mighty rivers with our bare hands.
It's Chris
and
Cruz.
And single buildings with a bound.
The living legend Larry Zbyszko, the American dream Dusty Rhodes. And gentlemen, I gotta tell you, one of the most intriguing matches at Uncensored in a week, live on pay-per-view, is Eddie Guerrero against Dean Malenko. Eddie, the U.S. champion. And you gotta figure, those two guys ought to be mad at six and not mad at each other for that no disqualification matchup.
I think you got a little trifecta there going on. I mean, Malenko obviously wants six, wants to get that cruiserweight belt back. Eddie Guerrero doesn't like six, but he's got the U.S. title. A lot of friction between Eddie and Dean Malenko. Just an unavoidable situation, but six, again, member of the New World Order. He's the man you want to focus on. That's the organization that's got to crumble. They already took a big blow last week,
yeah,
but we got to keep the pressure on them.
Yeah, let me say this, too. Legendary Larry Zbyszko, so right, getting ready to go into this spring break thing coming up at Nitro Live, coming up tomorrow, Monday. We always say anything can happen, and we have seen it happen. Boy, what a buster it was. But I'm still going back to the situation with these guys, these teams, WCW, the rules and the regulations that are outstanding in this match coming up at Uncensored. Piper has to have one of his guys left standing to win that thing and get the right to meet Hogan, who's already put a seat, get him in the cage, might get it done. I'm rooting for Piper, but I don't really think he made a wise decision with these guys he's picked. That's all I'm saying.
Well, the scary thing is, if any member of the NWO's team is the last one standing, the NWO then can challenge, can wrestle for any WCW title at any WCW event, anytime, any place in the world.
Yeah, that's true.
And also, if a member of WCW's team, of Lex Luger, the Giant of the Steiners, if one of those gentlemen, one of those wrestlers is left standing, the NWO has got to give back all of the WCW title belts, and then that's the last we'll see for 3 years.
Yeah, basically,
for the NWO.
Yeah, you don't even have to mention the
history.
Don't have to mention the 3 years even. They're out of here. It's history.
That's what we want to have happen. Of course, I'd love to see Piper make it into that cage match. He gets Hogan in the cage where he can keep all the New World Order out. He could put Hogan to sleep forever.
One man from each team, that is
just
three
like
men.
Snow White.
Begin that matchup, that main event at WCW's Uncensored. And then, there's some action there.
Gomez is down. I tell you, Pittman here in Parker looking good.
Yeah.
Maintaining control, good ring positioning, making tags.
At different intervals in that main event, three more men will come in. There can be as many as 12 men in the ring at one time.
It's going to be a wall.
And all pinfalls, knockouts, and submissions count in that matchup. Look at that shoulder.
I'll tell you what counts right here. Pittman needed to be more aggressive, and he's come out more aggressive, and he's got a good partner that needs to get to the pay window. And I guarantee you one thing, these young men, Renegade and Gomez, they've been to the pay window, and I know Pittman want to get back there. So very competitive situation right here on the pro.
Gets out of the code red.
Why?
Well, Pittman's looking a lot more aggressive now. He dumped Teddy Long, I think.
Well, no, I don't think that's the reason.
Tomorrow night live on WCW's Monday Nitro from Panama City, Florida, Club La Vela. Also, Savannah is going to be the site of Nitro on the 17th, Club La Vela, I beg your pardon, on the 17th of March. On the 22nd of March, we're in Minneapolis. On the 27th of March, in Baltimore, for WCW's Monday Nitro.
Legend to be going
home. It's not Minneapolis, it's Duluth.
Duluth. And that is way up by the border, and it's colder in the summertime there than it is anywhere in the world.
You are right. I stand corrected.
Both
Minneapolis and Baltimore are regular shows that we have, and we're preparing for Nitro. The Nitro on the 17th is from Savannah.
Wow.
Oh!
Renegade trying to deal here on Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker.
Up and boom!
That Parker way up there!
Spudheads. Now, where did that come from, Larry?
Midwest.
Ah. Same as Stahl. Look at that. Springboard elbow.
Springboard elbow and tagging Joe Gomez, who come in here. Got him in a backbreaker. This could be another trip to the bay window.
He's got him.
Oh, caught Parker off guard. I always said wrestling match three heartbeats away. I thought the points were stacking up in the favor of Pittman and Parker, but Gomez slipped in a beauty.
Look at that referee move. It's Scott Dickinson holding up the hands of the Renegade and the Desperado Joe Gomez. A whole lot more to come here on Superstation TBS, a week away from WCW's Uncensored. Footage from Nitro and more in a moment.